All right, questions for Coach Nate Wade?
So how's it been to go through your first spring here?
Outstanding. Guys work really hard. They're hungry. You know, it's, as a coach, that's what you want. You want them to buy in. And if you go through all spring and they're not buying in, you got an uphill battle. But when the guys are excited, then teaching techniques, it becomes more fun, a little bit easier to do.
How much more teaching do you do when you're installing a new defensive scheme at a program that you're new to than you have the last several years? When you don't have anybody who's returning who's familiar with all the scheme,
I'll be honest with you, it's a lot harder to come back in and install it. I'm not looking to do that during the spring. I think we set out to do this. We wanted to identify our personnel. We wanted to teach fundamentals, and we wanted to install just base defense. And we installed our base defense for when the quarterback's under center. And that's a great offense to go against. You'll be able to identify some guys that they're tough, you know, because the ball's coming right at you. It's a little bit more like a power game because you get a fullback downhill. You get to see out on the perimeter. You get to see the crack blocks and the arc and the cuts and all that. And it just, I told the guys today, I said, I don't know if you know how much better you're getting. Just playing with your pads out and your shoulders square and keeping your legs and things like that. All the fundamentals are what you win with. Schemes are easy to draw up, but the guys that are really good at getting off blocks and really good at tackling, that's where you win football games.
What was kind of your perception of this defense coming in, and has anybody stood out and surprised you in any way or anything like that?
I guess my perception was, here we go again. I want to do a better job of installing this defense than I did the first time that I had to do it. The things that I might have made mistakes in the past, you know, when I was going to a new school, I really sat down and I hate to make the same mistakes twice. And that's I know our staff gets tired of me, you know, mentioning that, but that's something that we always look at are the mistakes and making sure that we don't repeat those. So fundamentals, that's absolutely what we had to get taught. And then just teaching a couple of different fronts, you know, as far as our base, and just get the guys confident and being a football player. All the other things, all the gimmicks and mirrors and all that stuff, you know, for a defense, you know, show one thing, do something else. That's easy to do. Again, I know I repeat myself, but getting off blocks, it's hard to do. You know, tackling, especially in today's game, where you use the whole field. In my day, you know, everything was in the tackle box. Now they spread you out, and you got to be a great tackler. You know, so teaching those things is you know, whoever's the best at that. And I guess if you get the best players, then maybe that might make it a little bit easier. But if you get guys that are excited, you get guys that are motivated, there's an awful lot that you can do and do well.
When you look at the returning names that people were aware of, three of them were at the linebacker position, you know, with Swilling, Alexander, and Mitchell. Were you able to develop any depth in addition to those guys?
We have to. We just moved from a three linebacker defense to a four linebacker defense, and you know, that's not easy to do. We had to grab bar steel guys from other positions, and that's what we're going through. And that's part of the identification process. I got to identify our personnel and see who's going to fit best at that outside linebacker position, who's going to fit best at that inside backer position. And then, to be honest with you, there's a couple of freshmen that have stepped in that have done a really good job. You know, Jaquez and Charlie have stepped in, and one at the inside back, one at the outside backer position, and see, they're pushing. I don't have starters, and identifying the guys, the two deep, is the most important thing to me. So once we get a two deep and they come back in fall camp, now they can battle for that starting position. But I know at some point I'll be asked to identify the starters, and I'll put down, you know, this guy or the other guy, because that wasn't the goal. The goal was to come out of this thing, you know, with what is our personnel for our 2D, and teach fundamentals, install the base defense, and then get them hungry. Because if you wait till just before the season starts, it's too late. You wait till you know, the week before the first game, before you get hungry and excited, it's too late. You know, game pass you by.
What have you thought about the kind of level of athleticism and the personnel that you inherited compared to maybe what you've had before? Is it, are you seeing sort of the difference of?
It's a great question. I don't think that you can accurately predict how good they are until they know what they're doing.
True.
All right, so they're going through a learning process right now. So some of the guys that I think might be better than the others, all it is because some of them know what we're trying to teach a little bit better than the others. So a little bit more time, you know, will give me a better indicator of who is the best. So spring ball, you know, that's one thing, and then we got to get through camp, you know, and those first couple of weeks in camp, and we'll be evaluating the heck out of them because you better get that right, you know.
To that end, like in terms of just the types of bodies you have and skill sets that you've been able to identify so far, like how well do you think they fit what you want to do?
I think that the defensive front is a little bit different. It's a little bit more challenging because we were looking for maybe a little bit different type of body and different skill set when we were an even front. You know, now that we're an odd front, you know, you've got a little bit more ground to cover at times and a little bit different you know, footwork. So that's been the biggest challenge. Linebackers, you know, the gap changes a little bit more. So being able to see not only the ball coming, but being able to see the linemen as they wash down in front of you, and then be able to bend with that wash, that's important for those guys. So having some flexibility in the hips, great eyes at the linebacker position, and then who's better at going east and west, who's better at going north and south, will tell me who's better at inside and who's better at outside back.
You had two of your veterans missing at the safety position. Naturally, that would give some of the younger guys a chance to get more reps. What did you see there?
Oh, that was, you know, as hard as that was, having those guys miss, it was the best thing for us. You know, I think that Jalen and AJ having to sit out, I know they wanted to be in there, but I know those guys have some experience, and that experience is irreplaceable. But building the depth, that's what we've been trying to do, and that's been great for those guys. Great for them to get out there and get more reps, and great for us to see those reps and help us in evaluation stages.
Would it be fair to say that the folks in the secondary have less adjustment to make in the new defense than the front seven?
Absolutely, yes, no doubt. So I don't think there's a lot of difference in the back end other than whatever kind of coverage we decide is best for us. You always go into games, you always go into seasons with multiple coverages. And then as you get a feel or identity for your defense and what those guys can do best, that's what you tend to use more of. Maybe it's a two deep, maybe it's a one high safety. It could be man, it could be zone. It just depends on what your makeup is on that back end. And if you're asking them to do something they're not very good at, I guess you don't get employed very long. Right? So hopefully I'll do a good job of understanding what their strengths and weaknesses are and using those, you know, and asking them to do that instead of the things that they're not very good at.
How's your adjustment been to, you have all new staff, I mean, new Shield, but obviously the rest of the guys are new to you. Kind of how's that adjustment communication kind of getting
gelled? I'll be honest with you, Shield and I only worked on defense a couple of years together.
Yeah.
So, you know, that was good. But that's just been really good. The staff is, I always learn stuff from whatever staff I'm working with. And being able to draw, you know, the talents of Andy McCollum, you know, and seeing the things that he does best and getting advice from him. And Joe Speed, same thing. Just Joe is just great, you know, dot the I's, cross the T's guy. And I don't think there's ever a staff meeting where I don't ask those two you know, what, you know, what do you think about this or what do you think about that? It just make me a better coach. You know, Jerome Rise has had an awful lot of success with his defensive line and very familiar with the style that we play. And of course, Shield is coached on both sides of the football. He's coached on offense and defensive side, so that's always valuable, understanding what the offense is thinking in particular situations.
A couple more for Coach Woody.
Jaquan and Victor, we were both asking them about playing on the outside, and they were saying how you met with them, kind of explained to them, here's how I see you coming off the edge of the ring. What did you see in them that prompted you to think that's where they would fit? And for along the line, like how they kind of fulfilled that so far?
I knew both of them had speed. I knew that, heck, I don't even call Jaquan anymore. I call him Sonic Man. He can fly, you know, he can go. And he's got some flexibility in his hips where he can bend some coming off the edge. So I just think that makes it difficult for offensive tackles that are pointed in the wrong direction, you know, to be able to stop him and get to the quarterback. I think he can be a guy that can get pressure, you know, on the quarterback. I think he's a guy that can get off blocks and he can chase, you know, run and chase the football. And the outside backer position, that's something that I want. And I want that outside backer to be able to not just chase the ball, not just chase the ball carrier, but I like for him to chase the ball. I like for him to be able to get turnovers for us, takeaways, you know, whether he's you know, knocking the ball loose or whether he's recovering fumbles. I think Vic is a guy he's a guy that can turn speed into power, you know, in a heartbeat, you know. So whether he's working, you know, coming off the edge where he can get down low, up underneath pads, and get around the corner, or whether he turns it into a bull rush, either one, I think he becomes successful doing that. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I just thought the film that I studied showed that they had those qualities.
It seems like your defensive line, you sort of have an embarrassment of riches at the nose, and then are a little thinner just because of injuries at ends. Just kind of what have you seen from that group this spring?
I think there's some guys at the end position that move really good laterally. And in this game, against this offense, you got to have ability to move east and west, horizontal. I got some guys at the end position that they can do that. And I think there's some guys that are coming in as freshmen that can do that. Nose position is a lot more difficult, and that's what we're probably having a little bit more trouble with right now. That nose position is one that's what sort of what you build your defense around. If you don't have a great nose, not a good one, a great one, then this is a tough defense to execute. And you know, we got some bodies in there that are working hard and that have a chance to get there. But still, you know, we're in that fundamental phase, still teaching those fundamentals to where, you know, those guys can be just at a different level than what they're at now.
I guess frustration that you haven't had one guy kind of take hold there. It's been kind of different guys at nose, like,
well, just inconsistency and no different, I guess, really than all the positions, because you have you know, some guys out there that are playing that have experience, other guys are lacking that, and yet they want to show what they can do, and yet this is a whole different, you know, breed of cat, you know, when you're lining up there head up on the center. And if they single block you, you need to be able to make something happen. And if they don't double team you, then you know, you expect that nose to get off that block and make that tackle. And it's not just the nose. I mean, I think all guys up front, those all those defensive linemen, if you're getting single blocked, we expect you to beat that and penetrate